Today's client has had a problem with her nails for over 20 years. Today I'm going to educate her on how to take better care of her toenails and calluses at home to keep her feet pain-free. So stay tuned.
How long have you been dealing with your toes like this?
Forever.
Forever.
I'm gonna say 20 years.
Oh.
And another one of my friends, she get her hair done at this beauty shop in Canton. And I guess she saw the video, and when she showed it to her, and she was like, oh my Lord, my friend, she needs to see this video.
Yeah.
Because I always tell her, I have to do my feet before I get a pedicure. And that's terrible. They can't wait for me to come and give them the results. They wait on me. I said, you guys don't have bad feet like me, so she probably won't even take you.
Right.
My client says she's been dealing with her toes forever like this and is ready to get help and advice on how to take care of them at home because she can't find someone near her who can help her. She has to keep her calluses shaved down or she gets shooting pains in her feet and thinks her toes are starting to curl because of the way that she's been compensating when she walks to avoid the pain. So hopefully we can get her nails and calluses to a point where she can walk without any discomfort. The twists and turns of this nail is one of the biggest reasons using toenail nippers works best to trim toenails. You can't get a pair of regular toenail clippers around a nail like this. But you can insert the tip of the nippers into the nail and then squeeze and then move it around the shape of the free edge.
Okay.
A misconception about filing nails is that you have to file nails in one direction. Your goal is to not injure the client or to injure yourself. You aren't going to hurt the nail by filing back and forth or up and down as long as you're using light pressure to smooth the free edge with the file flush on the edge of the free edge and not at an angle where you could slice the skin on the toe. And I have a really, really old video explaining in detail about that that you could probably just search for.
So how long have you been waiting to get in?
Only took me maybe a week and a half or something.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, it wasn't bad.
You must have gotten a cancellation spot.
What's the normal?
Right now I don't have any openings for like 10 to 12 weeks.
Yeah, it wasn't that long. Maybe at the longest, I think maybe a couple. They looked at my picture and went, oh, we have a 911 in here. And you know, when you go to the shop and get your nails done, they just don't get under your nail and in between your skin and your nail.
Mm-mm.
And for me, I have to have that.
Mm-hmm.
Over the years of not getting it, then I get this buildup.
Yep.
and disappear your toenails. And even when I tell them, you gotta file the side of my nails. Oh, no. <You know? laughs>
Today's most liked comment is from Christy Miles. She says, absolutely, full pedicures should be considered as preventative, and insurance should pay for one every 60 to 90 days, just like a podiatrist. I have watched some horror videos of podiatrists and also in person when I worked nursing. My own grandmother lost her legs due to an ingrown toenail and poor circulation. I even talked a farmer into going into town for a pedicure with his daughters while caring for his wife. He came back, showed me his feet, and said they feel like I got a brand new set of tires. Thank you so much, Christy, for your input. I'll tell you, I wish they did too, but insurance companies are a for-profit business, and even though it would be wonderful if they would cover pedicures, they don't even cover getting your nails trimmed at the podiatrist unless you have an underlying medical diagnosis like diabetes or heart disease. Podiatrists are even starting to refer clients to nail technicians for even the basic maintenance because insurance doesn't reimburse them the fee at the level at which they require. So it's not even worth it for them to really do it anymore. It just depends on the contract and the agreement that they've made for reimbursement purposes. If you're in need of learning all of the types of bits and the electric file, when to use each bit, etc., the pressure to use to not cause injury, you can look at the individual courses link on my Academy website, academy.themeticulousmanicurist.com, for the electric file for pedicures course. It's hours of information and it will help you tremendously. And any individual course that you take can be credited toward the full certification at a later date if you choose to take that. The second foot is always so fun to watch because it's been soaking in the foot bath the entire time I've been working on the first foot, so all of the skin comes off so nicely.
You double booked yourself?
You know, I knew I would be in the chair, and I figured I could, you know,
straighten all the way out.
If you're still here watching, thanks so much. I know so many of you watch late at night to try to fall asleep, so I'll try not to get your brains thinking too much, but I really do want to know what your favorite tool is that I use. So drop it in the comments and stay tuned for the before and after photos. They're coming up in just a couple more minutes. Taking care of your nails sometimes might feel like a chore, but it is so good for you, and I'm right here to help you do it safely and with the best tools and instructions. So if you need help, just let me know. It really is about maintenance and prevention, so you don't end up with an issue that you have to restore. Okay, take care of yourself, and I'll see you next time.